How will you treat a patient of iron deficiency anemia?
Those who have hemoglobin more than 12 g/cent will maintain their hemoglobin level. So, only rechecking of hemoglobin levels in second trimester and third trimester is required. Those who have mild anemia, that is levels between 10 to 12 g/cent, will require iron supplements orally.
What are oral iron preparations?
Ferrous sulfate, ferrous fumarate and ferrous gluconate. Ferrous sulfate is very cheap, easily available as 200 mg tablet given 3 times a day, so that the total dose is 600 mg a day. 600 mg ferrous sulfate supplies about 160 mg of elemental iron, out of which 15% is absorbed, so the body receives about 27 mg, which is the requirement of a pregnant woman. This is given till the hemoglobin level reaches normal in about 6 to 8 weeks, followed by a maintenance dose of 1 tablet per day.
What are the side effects of oral iron?
Gastric irritation causing nausea and vomiting, colicky pain and diarrhea, blackening of teeth. These side effects are less with ferrous gluconate and ferrous fumarate. These side effects can be minimized by taking iron after food and in gradually increasing doses.
How will you know that the patient is taking iron regularly?
Ask the patient the color of the stools. Oral iron invariably makes feces black due to formation of iron sulfide.
Yes. What are the indications for parenteral iron therapy?
Parenteral iron therapy is indicated when patient cannot tolerate oral iron due to gastric side effects, when anemia does not respond to oral treatment, as in malabsorption syndrome, for severe anemia in late pregnancy, and when patient cannot be relied upon to take tablets regularly.
What are the parenteral iron preparations available?
Iron dextran or inferon and iron sorbitol citric acid complex, that is Zectofer. These are the two available preparations. Each ml contains 25 mg of elemental iron.
How is the injection made?
Deep intramuscular by Z technique.
Why?
It is a painful injection, hence it should be given deep intramuscularly, and it stains the skin black if it leaks into the subcutaneous tissue. Hence, Z technique is utilized.
What is Z technique?
The skin is pulled to one side when the injection is made, so that when released, the point of entry in the skin and the point of entry in muscle will not be in one line.
What are the side effects of intramuscular iron?
Local pain at the site of injection, skin discoloration, inflammation, tender regional lymphadenopathy, and systemic toxicity such as headache, backache, arthralgia, tachycardia, flushing, and sometimes circulatory collapse.
What is total dose iron therapy?
When a patient cannot tolerate oral iron or intramuscular iron or cannot be relied upon to take them regularly, total dose of iron may be given intravenously as a single dose.
How do you calculate the total dose of iron required?
25 mg of iron is required to raise hemoglobin by 1%, or total iron dose in milligram is equal to weight in pounds into hemoglobin deficit in percent into 0.3, and 500 mg added to this for stores and lactation. Or another convenient way in adults is to multiply hemoglobin deficit in gram percent by 255, which gives the total dose of iron in milligrams.
How do you give total dose iron?
An intravenous drip of 5% dextrose is started and 1 cc of inferon injected very slowly as test dose. After 10 minutes, if there is no side effect, the total dose of inferon is mixed into the intravenous bottle and given slowly over 6 hours.
What are the side effects of this therapy?
Side effects are more severe than intramuscular therapy. Anaphylactic reaction can occur within few minutes after starting infusion, and circulatory collapse is more severe. Subsequently, severe joint pains may occur for several days.
Can you describe the iron metabolism in short?
Daily iron requirement of elemental iron in a pregnant woman is 20 to 25 milligrams, out of which 15% is absorbed in mucous membrane in ferrous form. This ferrous form gets converted into a ferric compound, ferritin. Only certain amount of ferritin is formed so that excessive absorption is prevented. After absorption, iron circulates in blood bound to globulin as transferrin, which is used for hemoglobin production in reticuloendothelial system. It is stored as ferritin and hemosiderin. Phytates in food decreases absorption, while vitamin C increases absorption.
What is the treatment of very severe anemia with edema and breathlessness?
Patient should be hospitalized, propped up position should be given, oxygen is given, blood transfusion as pack cell 200 to 250 ml should be given very slowly to avoid overload to heart and heart failure. If signs of congestive cardiac failure are already present, digoxin and lasix should be started and blood transfusion monitored very carefully for signs of overload such as breathlessness, raised jugular venous pressure, etc. If required, transfusion is repeated after 2 to 3 days and oral iron or intramuscular iron therapy is started simultaneously.
What are the other indications for blood transfusion in pregnancy?
Severe anemia seen in late pregnancy, anemias not responding to hematinix, aplastic, hypoplastic and hemolytic anemias, and to combat bleeding episodes like antepartum or postpartum hemorrhage.
How do you treat macrocytic anemias?
Average daily requirement of vitamin B12 is 1 microgram and folic acid is 1 milligram. In macrocytic anemia, vitamin B12 is given as 10 injections of 1000 microgram daily and then every month, or 100 microgram tablet every day. Folic acid is given in the dose of 5 milligram per day.
What is the effect of anemia on pregnancy?
The main complication of anemia in pregnancy is premature labor with increased neonatal death rate due to prematurity. Secondly, in severe anemia, circulatory reserve is very low, and with even normal or moderate postpartum hemorrhage, patient may go into shock or cardiac failure. And lastly, incidence of puerperal infection is very high.
And what is the effect of pregnancy on anemia?
Pregnancy aggravates anemia by hydramnio of pregnancy and increased demands of iron.
What precautions will you take during the delivery of a severely anemic patient?
In the first stage, absolute bed rest, propped up position, oxygen, sedation and transfusion of back cells. No intravenous fluid should be given. In second stage, strict aseptic precautions should be taken to avoid infection. In third stage, ergometrin is given to prevent postpartum hemorrhage. Any blood loss should be immediately replaced by pack cells with continuous watch for congestive cardiac failure.
What advice will you give to the patient when she goes home?
I will advise her to continue oral iron for further 3 months. I will give dietary advice for balanced diet with plenty of green vegetables, beans, wheat, meat and eggs. And I will ask her to follow up after 2 months to check that anemia is fully treated.
This is the end of the fourth clinic in obstetrics on anemia in pregnancy.